Hello everybody, my name is Alessandra Zanazzi and I work at Istituto Nazionale di Astrofisica, the Italian National Institution for Research in Astrophysics and Space Science. But also we are very strongly committed to astronomy communication with the public and to the diffusion of the astronomical and scientific culture. And in this framework, we run a project which is a cultural project connecting art, tourism, history, and astronomy. Actually, this is an astrotourism project, but what do we mean with astrotourism? If you Google the word astrotourism, you will find information about visiting beautiful places where you can look at perfectly starry night, perfectly dark skies. Maybe you go and search for astronomical phenomena like aurora borealis or eclipses, or you go and visit observatories, public observatories, or professional observatories. But we thought that we could add a cultural perspective to astrotourism. In fact, in Italy, we have a unique concentration of monuments, history, and art masterpieces. So this is Florence, where I live. We know that inside these monuments and historical places and buildings, there is a lot of astronomy. And for many years in different Italian cities, the local researchers and astronomers at ENAF observatories, they carried out visits and activities connecting history, art, and astronomy inside the monuments in the cities. A lot of people participating in this event. There is a strong engagement. For example, these are pictures of the Cathedral of Florence, where around summer solstice, around the 21st of June, you can observe the sun entering the church and crossing the meridian line, because the Florence Cathedral, and in particular the Brunelleschi Dome, is the tallest sundial in the world. And also, this is another picture of San Miniato al Monte, always in Florence. This is a medieval, beautiful church. In the floor, there is a zodiac engraved, the marble zodiac, and it is also around the 21st of June, you can observe the sun entering the church and hitting the cancer on the zodiac on the floor. This is really a fascinating event. A lot of people participate and a lot of people are engaged. And especially what is interesting for our point of view is that these people are not necessarily people that normally come to the observatory or normally are attracted to science and astronomy, not necessarily. So it's a way also of reaching different audiences, different kind of audiences, different visitors, different people, different interests. So we in the framework of this project, we keep going with these visits, of course, but also we thought about writing a guidebook of the astronomical places, an astro-touristic guidebook. Actually, not one, it's a series of books already, because we have the one for Padua, which was the first one. Then I wrote the one for Florence, and then there is another one in Palermo that is going to be published in summer, next summer, in a few months. We did this work in collaboration with the Pablé Illustration, which is a communication agency based in Padua, and they are very good at carrying out cultural and scientific dissemination projects, but they are especially carried out with great care and research on the graphical aspects. There are a lot of graphics, graphic design, a lot of details, beautiful images, and attention to these aesthetics, let's say. So the guidebook are designed to be attractive, easy to use, easy to read. They are written in a simple language, understandable for everybody, not for expert, not only for expert, not specialistic. Full of curiosity, full of connection to traditions and curious happenings, local tradition, religious needs in different periods, in different culture of the different periods, and also maybe mysteries. So they are easy and accessible. These are images of the guidebook of Palermo, which is not published yet, okay? Every guidebook has a detachable map, and in the so that it will be easy to find the monuments in the guidebook, and also in the guidebook in the map, they are marked with different colors, representing like grouping the places in three different itineraries. So for example, in the case of Florence, we have the green itinerary is the one about time, measurement of time. So there will be sundials, clocks, also mechanical clocks. The second one is the purple one, is on the footprints of Galileo Galilei. And so there is the house where he lived the last part of his life, which is in Arcetri, and the church where he was buried twice, and so on. And then the third one, the yellow itinerary, is about the sky maps and earth maps, and so geographical maps, but as well as painted sky and zodiacs. But what else? The project doesn't end with this, with the book. Of course, we are planning many more activities. Of course, we will keep going with the walk with an astronomer, with the astro-touristic tours, which could be addressed to different audiences, to different target groups. For example, for citizens who they normally are not aware of the astronomy content or the monuments in their cities, but also for tourists and for different age school groups. For example, we are also working to carry out tours for school groups. And then we are planning to translate at least into English the guidebooks to make sort of, so to say, technological enhancements of the guidebooks of the itineraries, for example, through virtual reality tours, like in Palermo, they are working on it, or in Florence, we are working with the municipality. They are developing an application for smartphone and tablets, and to containing different itineraries of the city freely download. And so there will be the astronomical itinerary as well. Also the family children guidebook, which is already has been published for Padua, and we are going to publish it for Florence and for the other city, hopefully. It has a completely different layout and aspect, but it's very nice, and it has very nice illustration by Mariana Rio, and also other information for children activities and so on. Then we have also other ideas I will tell you about next time. Any suggestion you may have, or comments or information you want to ask, feel free to contact me. This is my address. And thank you very much for your attention.